Greetings, LGR here, or at least my hands, since I have my camera glasses on. And today's video is just going to be very off the cuff, not really planned at all, because this wasn't planned at all, or at least not exactly. I ended up getting all of this stuff here that is on the floor from right here all the way, all of this, in one lot from a local collector. And I actually ran into him on a vintage computer forum recently and saw that he had a bunch of IBM PS2 stuff for sale. And, you know, I've always been curious about this system and series of systems in particular. There are six PS2 systems in here, complete and working, got the monitors and everything. What we're gonna basically do is just look at all of this stuff. And I haven't actually gone through all these boxes yet, so I'm not even sure what I'm going to find. But let's go ahead and just sort of dive in. All right, now, first things first, there are the computers themselves. And this is pretty much a mixture of model 60s, model 80s, model 90s. I guess there's one 95 in here somewhere. We're gonna start with this one right here. This is the model 90 XP486. This is one of them that I know for sure is in fully working order. I actually got to test it out before even buying it. And yeah, it's just a neat little 486 machine that's actually set up for networking. In fact, I think all of these are. The guy that I got it from, Paul, he was actually working on putting together this really cool like networking thing for all of these, but he didn't get to finish it, and he's got other stuff to work on in the meantime. So yeah, you just kind of got rid of all of this stuff. Thank you once again, Paul. You're a super awesome dude. A lot of fun to talk to as well. But yeah, so this thing is pretty decked out as it appears. Everything but a sound card. He said he took that out, but I'm gonna be putting that back in, of course, because why not, man? These others down here, we have, these are model 95A servers. And these are just, you know, I don't have any experience with them whatsoever, but I like them. I like the fact that it comes with these 2.88 meg floppy drives, as opposed to the one up here and the ones that you would normally see, which are 1.44 meg. These can be formatted with that IBM format floppy, which I think I actually have. These are 2 meg floppies. These might be able to be formatted at 2.44. I'm not entirely sure. I've had these around for a while, but we'll give them a shot and find out sometime. But yeah, these CD-ROMs that you're seeing here, and also on the one up here with the other Model 90, these are Caddy CD-ROM drives. They don't have a tray. You stick the CD in a little Caddy disc. Maybe I'll find some of them over here in these other boxes. But yeah. And this is actually like the only thing on any of these that's really yellowed too, which I'm happy with, because yellow computers are not happy computers. These are very happy looking. You know, look at these things though. I love these. These are the model 60 and a model 80. There's 2 model 80s in here, or is it 2 model 60s? Yeah, okay. So this is a model 80. This is a model 80. This is a model 60. As far as I know, I think he said this is the one that he used the most as far as just being all decked out with cool stuff. We got another, it's like another Caddy CD-ROM drive over here. Those things were really popular for a time, especially on computers like these. They're all high-end and stuff. Really cool thing about these though, other than being just friggin' huge and awesome, are the fact that they're technically portable. Check this thing out. Okay, I'm gonna try to move this. Okay, these are friggin' heavy. So, obviously, it's really heavy, right? But this right here is like the most robust handle I've ever seen. And it makes moving them around way, way easier. Not easy necessarily, but easier. All right, I'm going to... All right, let's just take a look at the back of this one here. This is the 8580 model. So yeah, series 80 computer. Apparently this one here, I love that red power switch. Look at that. Oh man, says, do not turn this machine off. This was at one point a server. I think he said for a school. A lot of these, I think, came from schools. This is a little bit different too. This is another Model 80, but this is a, I don't know if you can see it there, a Model 8386. So this one has a 386 in it. And so we get a slightly different CPU and internal setup here going on, which I want to cover at some point in videos of their own. But as of today, I'm really just gonna be going through the rest of this. So let's go ahead and take a look at the monitors now too. All right, now these two monitors here are really nothing too special. They're just basic PS2 color VGA monitors. This is the, I think, 8515 model, and I know this one is an 8513, a little bit smaller. Basically the same thing though, and like I said, they're just VGA monitors. Nothing too ridiculous or anything like that, but very cool to have. I like those looks of these old IBM monitors. He also gave me this. A little bit of screen burn in there. This is an old Hitachi Electronics monitor, but it's really just an old black and white TV. Oh. All right, so you can see here is manufactured in 1976. This he actually had for his VIC-20, although I've also seen these kind of things hooked up to Apple IIs and even Apple Is, and just really whatever else. I love the look of these just like utilitarian black and white TV slash monitors. He says it still works last time he checked, so can't wait to try it out. Now this monitor here, this is a different story. This is the 8516, and it may look more or less like the others, but if you look on the back here, you can see that it has another port here. This is a PS2 port, and there's also an extra cable. Now, what this is actually an old touchscreen monitor. So you have the PS2 cable here, plugs into your computer, and then your other, like your mouse, will go into the back of the monitor, from what I read. And this is just a regular VGA cable. And then with the right software, this thing is actually an 80s VGA touchscreen monitor. And I don't know how exactly it works. This is something I want to do like an oddware video on and really inspect it. But as far as I know, it's not capacitive or anything. It's like one of those pressure-based ones like you'd find on an old ATM. This is so cool. I didn't even know that there were PC monitors that were touchscreen back then, so this is gonna be fun. Now, the only other really big piece of functioning hardware that I got was this IBM Pro printer. This is the XL24 model, and it's one of those like lined V dot matrixes. I think these are really neat. This one's, well, a pro printer. This front is coming off here, but he said he just pretty much put it back in place and it works. I guess we'll see. But yeah, and it also came with a bunch of ribbons, some cables and stuff. The ribbons are brand new, he says, but they've been in here for like, I don't know, 20 years or so. Who knows if they've dried up or not, but I guess I'll find out. Oh yeah, almost forgot about this guy here. This is an external SCSI hard drive. It doesn't have any branding on it, but it fits in rather aesthetically with these other IBM computers, so this is cool. No idea why it's got RCA out on the back here. I'm assuming maybe that this could also be used for a couple CD-ROM drives, like, you know, a couple half height drives. But yeah, it's got a big old beefy, I think 40 meg drive in there right now. Let's see, we've also got a power supply here that I think is for the Model 60, perhaps the Model 80, I don't know. Either way, it's good to have, and he said this functions as well. So that's awesome. Apparently these things are quite expensive. All right, so now I've got all these boxes to go through. Like I said, I haven't gone through any of these yet, so I'm really not even sure what I have. But, well, let's discover it together. Let's just start with this one. This is network coax. I'm assuming it's coax cables. What do you know? It is. Oh, man. All right. Don't know what this one is. It's unmarked. Oh, I think this is the external floppy drive, or is it the... No, this is an external CD drive. This is pretty cool. Another Caddy drive. This is an NEC, a 4-speed, it looks like. And yes, also SCSI as well. That makes sense. Cool. I like Caddy drives. Hey, this one is marked Win 3.11 diskettes and SCSI hard drives. I assume that's what it is. In fact, yeah, here's a 1 gig SCSI drive by IBM. Oh man, a bunch of drives in here. All the 3.5-inch form factor looks like. There's a 300 meg one. Aha, so here is one of the Caddy CD-ROMs. So basically, it's kind of like a big 3.5-inch floppy disk thing, you know, or at least with the mechanism. So you actually place your CD in here, face down. It's got the little spinny spindle thing right there that you would normally see internal of a CD-ROM drive. And then this, yeah, it's just going to go and plop in there like that. And of course, if it's turned on, the mechanism will pull it the rest of the way in. Very neat. Let's see, antivirus toolkit by Dr. Solomon. Ooh, neat. I like the antivirus stuff. This mostly appears blank. Oh, there's some DOS 622 plus enhanced tools. Well, I don't see any Win 3.11 discs, or if they are in here, they're not labeled. Too bad, it's so damn hot in here. That's probably what killed my glasses. AT hard drive? Oh yeah, actually did take a look at this before I bought it. Right, so yeah, in here, I got an old Seagate full height floppy drive. This is an ST4038. 40 whole megabytes of, looks like MFM goodness. Oh yeah, I know what's in this one. It is not an Onkyo stereo amplifier. It is in fact IBM keyboards. This is a much newer keyboard. Doesn't click or anything, but these other ones that are in here, look at these babies. Clicky keyboard goodness. All, I guess, IBM Model M's. Yeah, this one's from 1984. This one looks a bit newer here. This is 1993, rather. Let's see, what was this one then? 91. Okay, look at all these Model M's. It is just beautiful. Oh, there's a 1995. This is one of the Lexmark ones. These came much later. But yeah, I love IBM Model M's, and to have so many of them now is, oh my goodness, I need to wipe away a tear. Okay, no idea what's in this one at all. I have not opened it. Oh crap, that's a lot of RAM. Lots of RAM. Oh my word, I have enough RAM forever. There's a rubber band on that one. Oh, a 2 megabyte memory module for the PS2. I love this box. Lots of SCSI cards in here, it looks like. Keep finding bags of them. Networking cards, this is all SCSI. Like the entire rest of this is SCSI networking for days. Oh man. Well, I guess if I ever need to network an entire school's worth of computers, I can do that. I just love these tubes of RAM. Like what? They're tubes. Tubes! Let's see here, IBM Personal System 2 Data Migration Facility. There's an entire facility in here, guys. Let's see. Oh, well, that's neat. Yeah. Because you really need a box this big for something that size. We have here a box of saddle grip connectors. You know, somehow I doubt it. Oh, look, it's floppies. Windows for work groups. An introduction to microwave tubes. Oh, that's just about the geekiest thing I've ever seen. I love it. Yes. Whole bunch of stuff in here. Random utilities. Looks like college stuff. Emergency boot disk. Yeah, that is an emergency when you have to boot Windows 95. Speaking of Windows 95, yeah, this is the floppy disk release. It's never been opened. I've only installed it from floppies once and I will never do it again. So these are probably gonna stay closed forever. This is a hard disk controller card. It looks like an 8-bit hard disk adapter by Silicon Valley Computer. Oh, now that is actually very handy. I have a couple computers I could use this in. All right, spare motherboard for the Model 90XP. That will come in handy. It looks like there's been some interesting work there done with the traces. Some compact stuff in here. This is interesting. There's definitely no ProLiant computers in this set of stuff that I got, but... Ooh, I like this. You'll have to give me a moment anytime that I run across all of this software stuff, even for compact. In fact, I like early 90s compact stuff. This looks like from 1994 or so. Yeah, Microsoft Windows NT from Compaq. Oh, now this is useful. So this is a service guide, a quick reference to all the old Compaqs from back then. Oh, that's really cool. I wonder if my, yep, it is. The Contura. I did a video on the Contura Aero, a 430 a little while back. Or was it the 420? I think mine was a 420, but anyway, yeah. All sorts of quick information, all the jumper locations and stuff, hard drive matrices. Oh, yes. I will actually use that. My, oh my, this is a lot of compact software. A lot of original compact software. Oh, that old logo. I missed that. A lot of netware stuff in here, which, yeah, I mean, again, that really just makes sense considering this. The dude I got it from, super into networking. I wonder if he did some sort of work with compact restoration, or not restoration really, but like, yeah, like configuring them or setting them up or supporting them, I guess, because a lot of this is like, wow, non-compact option configure. I mean, this is valuable stuff. I'm gonna have to image these discs because, yeah, this is good. Yeah, I was hoping this was in here somewhere. This is the IBM 4869 external 5 1/4 inch floppy drive. And this is just neat because, you know, if you notice those, the computers down there don't actually have any external floppy drives. Wait, what? No, any 5 1/4 inch floppy drives, but there's an external one here. And of course, the thing with these is that, they're only going to work with a machine that supports it. I have one for Tandy 1000 series computers. This only works with Tandys. So this one is cool, but yeah, pretty much only for these PS2s. But that's good because I like having at least one 5 1/4 inch drive for systems of this vintage. Oh, more Windows 95 floppy disks. Yep, those will stay sealed too. 2.0 meg. Formatted disks. That's nice. Still sealed. Some copied DOS CDs. Bunch of Norton stuff. We got antivirus, utilities, Dragon Netherly speaking, more utilities, PFS Resume Pro. At least this is a older school Norton. Actually, these are for, this one's for Windows NT 4.0. That's pretty cool. Ooh. We have a magneto optical disc here. This, I actually covered the worm drive on Oddware quite a while ago, and this is what those will, or that system will use. Let's see, more empty caddies. Oh, hey, Windows 3.0. This is cool. Okay, I did not have that. I had 3.1, 3.11, Microsoft mouse drivers, paintbrush. That's a must. I've actually got a boxed version of Microsoft Paintbrush to cover. Let's see, MS-DOS, probably 5.0, I'd have to guess. Maybe 4, I don't know. What? Dangerous Dave. Look at all those floppy labels. Well, labels for floppies, I mean, the labels are floppy too, but that's not what I meant. And also some random software in here. We got CorelDRAW, Pinnacle Express, and CDRW drivers. No, those are just blank media. Multimedia, US history, ooh. More CorelDRAW, Acrobat 3.0, and WinZip. No way, is this... Is somebody actually register WinZip? It is! Holy crap! Oh man, I've done it! I have found the one registered copy of WinZip ever. Oh man. I can't believe somebody actually bought this. Oh, what a sucker. Okay, let's see what this is. This is a box of boxed software, it appears. Norton Utilities, version 5.0. Number one hard disk utility, InfoWorld 1990. Yep, I'd say so. This is actually very friggin' useful. Oh yeah, actually I'm gonna put this right over here with my other boxed tools and utilities and software and stuff. Yes, old school Norton. A later version of the competitor, McAfee Utilities, awful. Let's see, Lantastic 6.0, networking software. I thought that said Atari Soft at first. That's Artist Soft. Cool. Ah, friggin' Myst, of course. Because, you know, there's a copy of Myst in literally like every bundle of software that I've ever gotten. Central Point software. Oh, this is PC Tools Deluxe. Good. I was actually wanting a box copy of this. This is version 5.5, 1989. Oh, yeah. This is some extremely useful stuff for DOS. I like it. This is also going on that shelf. Sensei Calculus by Broderbund. Oh, man. And I thought the microwave tube disc was geeky. This is right up there in the world. It's just floppies and floppies of calculus. That's amazing. Oh, that's cool. And let's see, last thing in this box is ClickNet 2 version, or no, you ClickNet version 2. Don't know what this is. Okay, for its network diagramming software. Okay. Probably never going to use that, but hey, it's cool to have. That's a beefy box. I like that. Looks like some documentation for the model 90XP486. Oh, yes. I like it. I approve. I love reference guides. Well, the floppies aren't original, but that's okay. Neat. I will peruse that when I'm taking a dump. We've got a lot of floppy drives in here, it appears. Some 2.88 meg floppies, 1.44s, there's a hard drive of some kind. Floppy. Some controller cards, a lot of hard drives. Good grief. Well, if one of these drives in those computers ever goes out, looks like I've got plenty of replacements to choose from. That's good. What's in here? Oh, a piece of plastic. I've always wanted one of these. Oh, this is intriguing. Intel. It's like an Intel tobacco tin. Whoa. Oh, this is cool. Texas Instruments 486 DX2 66 CPU. Microsoft Windows compatible. And like an Intel tin. See if I can get it out of there. Yeah, it comes right out. Oh, it's in beautiful shape. Oh yeah, that is a nice processor. I love this tin. You're gonna go somewhere safe and awesome Right up here by the Lego TIE Fighter. That's right. More caddies. Holy crap, are these all CD-ROMs? They look like. Oh, nice! Okay. If you don't know what this is, this is not a Starship, but kind of looks like it. This is actually an external CD-ROM drive. One that plops in like this, like a PlayStation or like an NEC game console, which, you know, it's an NEC branded thing, you know? Oh, this is neat. I like this a lot. Just the design. Yeah, the rest of this appears to be, it's also a caddy drive. There's not a single tray loading CD-ROM drive in this whole hall. Yep, also a caddy, this looks like it has one in it. Oh, Visual Basic 6 for Dummies Deluxe Compiler Kit. Oh, that's different. Not just your typical book, it's got, yeah, a bunch of software and, that's pretty neat. Cool. I might actually put that on a shelf. DOS 5 instant reference. Oh man, I referenced everything instantly. That was quick. Let's see what's in here. Oh man, another game. Sportware Golf. By HarperCollins Interactive. That, you know, considering the rest of the software we found, that's about the most appropriate game that I could ever hope to find. JFK Assassination Encyclopedia. What? Ooh, Print Shop Deluxe. I like that version. And on CD, that's cool. And the rest of this is Popular Mechanics. More Novell netware. This is Hewlett Packard stuff. There's a lot of netware stuff in here. Look at this. This is all copied netware. This disc was handed in for a grade at school. It might help someday. This was on a 3.11 network. What is this? It's just, I'm keeping this out. I mean, it might help someday. More and more software. Let's see. More 6.2 version of MS-DOS utilities of some kind here. Windows 3.11. Oh, here's my Windows 3.11 stuff. Yeah, it's all in here. Neat. Ooh, a Tandy floppy holder. That is always fun to see. Those don't look like floppies, though. Yeah, they are indeed not floppies. They are data cartridges, 120 megs. I was hoping I'd find some of these because, actually, here we go. I don't know if you noticed, but this one model 80 down here actually has a data like cartridge backup system. So the tape goes in there like that. Oh, don't do that. Okay. And if it's on, then, you know, it's like the caddy that'll pull it in there and do its thing. You can actually back up data onto tapes. So yeah, just looking around the rest of this in here, and it's all like a bunch of backed up floppy disks for all these different computers. I mean, just loads and loads of drivers, utilities, backup things, everything, just for all the hardware that it came in. Look at all this. I don't think I'm in any shortage of needing the files to run and back up these systems, assuming they work, the systems and the disks, really. Some of the systems do, but I don't know about all of them. This is the final box here. And it mostly appears to be, well, here's some Windows 95 distributions. There's a Gateway 2000 one, at least the license for it. That's neat. Some Four Dummies books. MCSE for Dummies. That's one I don't have. I do have these others. Oh, here's a classic, Upgrading and Repairing PCs by Q. Fifth edition. The only DOS book you'll ever need. Why do I have all the rest of this stuff then? Screw it. Let's see. Ooh, Windows 3.11. Still sealed on 3.5-inch floppies. Oh, yes. That's always good to have another one of those. Aha, some documentation for my printer over there. So when it inevitably fails, I can bash my head against this. Printers. Ooh, PS2 Model 80 quick reference. Oh, good. A reference disc. Oh, This is so IBM, the entire binder is blue. Model 80 technical reference, wow. Oh man, it's even got color-coded tabs. Whoever put this together is serious about their references. I mean, it doesn't get any more legit than colored tabs, that's for sure. Okay, yeah, this right here. So this is interesting. The guy that I got this from, Paul, he said that it also, a lot of this came from like an IBM sales rep or like an authorized like remarketer type of dude. And he kept like impeccable records. He called him, I think, particularly anal about record keeping and keeping notes. And look at all this stuff. This is great. I mean, I love this. Oh, man. Tons of information about like every individual component that's inside of these computers. The IBM Personal System 2 Comparative Guide from IBM. That is neat. So if you want to read all this boring information about the comparisons of the PS2 systems, that's, you can do it. And I love reading this boring stuff. Look at this, you've got like benchmarks and stuff here, like Excel on OS2 versus Windows 3.0. It actually appears that Windows was a little bit faster running Excel, at least for OS2 version 1.2. It's an excerpt from PC Magazine, 1991. Controversial Intel 486 chip debuts in IBM's PS2 Model 90 XP, which is the computer I'm sitting all this crap on at the moment. Wow. So, yeah, this is that the previous owner of this stuff. He actually kept records of, it's like magazine articles and everything. This is cool. This is like an IBMer's scrapbook. I love this. Oh yeah, here we go. This is the guy. Sullivan and Associates, or just Sullivan Associates, Pennsylvania. Oh my God. Look at the prices. January 31st, 1991. For the computer, the monitor, that external disk drive, and the printer, $8,898. This is so cool. I love having paperwork on computers that I get. You know, it's like the difference between just picking up some random computer that's nothing but a case and then having, you know, just this fully fledged thing. You know, it's like buying a car that sucks, right? Like it's just some thing and it doesn't matter. But if you buy a car that has all the paperwork and like articles and stuff that the guy got probably while researching it or something. I mean, this is before this computer was out. Oh my God, look at this. $17,745 for a Model 95 tower. I can see why he went for the desktop. It's $1,000 less. Jeez, dude. When you can tell a computer was somebody's like pride and joy, even if it was like for a business or something, I mean, this dude obviously cared to spend that much money and keep all the records and everything. It's like, yeah, I'm gonna give you a proper home here.
Oh yeah, we got the beast plugged in. Everything's hooked up. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Wonderful red power button over here, which that's good. And here we go. Come on, picture. Yeah, IBM. Man, doesn't this just look like a cash register? Which is, I think these are basically the same displays that they used on a lot of cash registers, you know, like POS systems and stuff. Classic. Yeah, at least that works. I'm gonna go into the setup and see what we got here. I'm really curious. I haven't actually done that yet. Oh, I guess we got 32 megs of RAM. That's good. Okay. Ah. Yeah. Okay, cool. So we got 32 megs of RAM. We do have a Math GoPro. That's cool. I like that stuff. 66 megahertz, 486 DX2. Oh, yes. Yeah, there's some pretty sexy stuff on this thing. We'll have to see what kind of SCSI stuff is on here, because there is something plugged into that in the back. Okay, so the hard drive. And I guess the CD-ROM makes sense. And then you have the external connection on the back there. Very cool. I don't care. I just want to hear that sound. Along with the typing of the keys. Ah, DOS prompt. I don't think we'll need a mouse, but just in case we do, I'm gonna put it right there. Okay, let's see what we got. MS-DOS 6 at least. Gigabyte hard drive, 16. Okay, sweet. Yeah, I'm already there. All right, yeah. It wanted to boot into Windows earlier, and I was like, no, don't do that. That's gonna. It actually has Windows 95 on here, but I think that is absurd. We're just gonna run this thing straight DOS. I do know what I want to try, though. It's our mystery floppy here. It may help someday. What's on here? Ooh, documents. Auto exec? What the heck is on there? All right, so this is made to do LAN workspace. Okay, I guess that makes sense since they said it was put on some sort of networked IBM. All right, well, let's see what happens when we open one of those. I'm not asking you to write. Yeah, you know what? I could get another computer running in the time. Not quite a PS2, but you'll do. Because at least the HP Vectra is fast in comparison. Come on now, you can do it. You can open the mysterious disk. Oh. Okay. I guess that was, well, that's a bit of a letdown. It's not quite the national treasure epic moment that I was hoping for. But I guess, you know, I mean, if you needed to do some sort of workstation preparation for your network, then this was a very important disk, indeed. The second file doesn't open at all. And I guess that's just how it's gonna be. Oh, is it actually? No, yeah, it still doesn't open. Unexpected errors. Yeah, that's kind of disappointing. Go ahead and shut down. All right. Ouch. And this one still does not want to load. That is pretty ridiculous. Well, we're going to turn you off. I need to reformat and get this thing going again because that is the slowest thing in the world. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and let me know what of this stuff you would like to see covered on LGR. Otherwise, I'm just going to assume all of it and I'm going to cover all of it at some day. But yes. Thank you for watching. And if you'd like to see some more videos, then, you know, do it. I'm not gonna stop you. I'm not gonna help you either. Just, you know, click things. You'll get there.